How much damage difference between Birth of Cell versus Deicosmos fell for Herta? Let's find out.
私が誰だか知ってるの？こんな大きなダイヤモンド見たことないでしょ。あげるね。
For the ultimate, Cosmos is better and the difference is 18% with 26.5k damage difference.
くるくるっと。
For the follow-up attack, Cosmos is better and the difference is 2.5% with 734 damage difference. For the skill, Cosmos is better and the difference is 17.7% with 3.2k damage difference. For the skill, Cosmos is better and the difference is 17.5% with 15.1k damage difference. For the follow-up attack, Cosmos is better and the difference is 3.2% with 877 damage difference.
私が誰だか知ってるの？こんな大きなダイヤモンド見たことないでしょ。あげるね。
For the ultimate, Cosmos is better and the difference is 18.4% with 5.3k damage difference.
私が誰だか知ってるの？こんな大きなダイヤモンド見たことないでしょ。あげるね。
For the ultimate, Cosmos is better and the difference is 18.1% with 15.9k damage difference.
くるりんと。
For the follow-up attack, Birth of Self is better and the difference is 10.2% with 5.5k damage difference. The only time that Birth of Self is better is when the passive 96% is on or when the enemy HP is below 50%. Other than that, the Cosmos is overall better as long as you can activate the passive. If we compare the uptime, if the enemies are small, you can get that 96% benefits more often, for example in pure fiction. Other than that, if you fight big enemy, you basically can only activate the follow-up attack once when the big enemy goes below 50% HP, and after that you will benefit nothing from the follow-up attack damage increase. In conclusion, I recommend using the Cosmos. Not only it feel better, but it's also completely free.